We know that you absolutely loved season one of Shadow and Bone, and why wouldn't you love the show? It was an amazing adaptation of Leigh Bardugo's book having the same name. We did talk about what we know about the second season and when it will be releasing, but considering the fact that we don't know anything about the release date and how much we will have to wait for the second season, let's talk about some facts regarding season one of Shadow and Bone, facts that you didn't have any clue about. So without further ado, let's begin the video. Number 10, 250 keftas. Keftas were one of the most used outfits for the Grishas. There were specifically three versions of the keftas used in the show. One was used to wear during wars, the second one for everyday use, and the third one was for social occasions like the winter fete. The first one was completely bulletproof, the second one was made of velvet, and the third one was made of silk. All of these keftas were hand-embroidered in a style called bullion embroidery.
You're not wearing your kefta.
Did you not like the color I chose for you?
You're the only one who wears it.
Tell me, are you so anxious to be like everyone else?
It'd be nice to know what that feels like someday.
In addition, there were actually small pieces of metal embroidered in the dresses. However, one thing that the fans of the show might not know is that there were a total of 250 keftas made for the show, meaning that the makers of the show got 250 keftas hand-embroidered, which is amazing and shows the level of commitment showed by the costume design crew. Number 9. Goats. Goats can sometimes be probably the most adorable animals out there. The goats surely made viewers adore them in the show. However, in reality, the goats on the sets of the show were a real menace. They would run around everywhere on set, would knock down equipment here and there, pooping on the set, and would create this unbearable smell. Also, when they were in scenes, they would just start screaming for no reason at all, forcing the director to redo the scene every single time. Goats do look pretty cute in the show, but in reality, they caused a lot of trouble on the sets of Shadow and Bone.
We'll wait.
Jasper, grab the goat.
I'm not throwing out the goat!
Grab the damn goat! It's not bait, it's for you! I need you to calm down. Hug the goat. Shut the hell up.
It's so soft.
Number 8. A friendly bond. Who doesn't like working on a thing where he could have fun and make really good friends? Well, the cast of Shadow and Bone share a very beautiful and friendly bond with each other. They became great friends, which can be seen through their Instagram posts where the cast can be seen hanging out together. Jessie made sure that she included all of her Shadow and Bone buddies in the posts. The cast would get lunch, sing songs and play the piano in their spare time, have movie nights, and watch the Great British Bake Off in their pajamas during their free time. No wonder the chemistry between the star cast of the show was so amazing. Good relations off the sets often result in good performances on the set. Number 7. The cast did their own stunts. Having stuntmen on the sets of your show to perform stunts for your star cast has always been a very common thing in movies and shows over the years. With the advancement of visual technology, it's really easy to let a stuntman do all the stunts and then make it look like the actor is performing the stunts. But in some instances, actors choose to do their own stunts in order to make things look real and effective. Shadow and Bone has a lot of action sequences, and most of those action sequences have been performed by the star cast itself. Suman even got a scar while performing her stunts in the knife fight scene. They did need the help of professional stuntmen in order to perform the stunts correctly though, but the kind of action that the show had, it's definitely remarkable.
Oh, damn!
That's how you came out.
Number 6. Jessie had ADHD while shooting. Jessie did a fantastic job in the show, didn't she? But what if I tell you that she was going through a serious mental disorder while shooting for the show? This wasn't known during the show's shooting, but everyone noticed that Jessie could not sit still during shoots and pre-shoots. This got everyone worried, and the show's crew asked Jessie to get a mental checkup to see if everything was okay. She was later diagnosed with ADHD. Working so well while carrying such a disease is pretty remarkable and tough. We hope Jessie recovers from this disease as soon as possible.
What are you?
A map maker, sir.
Quiet.
Number 5. The cast took proper martial art training for their roles. As we said previously in this video, most of the stunts you see during the running minutes of the show were performed by the star cast themselves. There was a special form of martial arts used in the show. It was a Russian martial arts technique known as sistema. All of the actors of the show had to learn this martial arts technique from qualified instructors in order to perform their own stunts with utter perfection. No wonder the fight sequences in the show were so well choreographed. This also shows the hard work put in by the actors of this show, as performing their own stunts was totally their call. If they did not want to learn all of these martial art techniques and fighting styles, they could have gone for a stuntman, but they chose to do it on their own, a fact that needs to be appreciated. Number 4. The cast used the books for reference. As we all know, the show Shadow and Bone is based on the original book with the same name. Shadow and Bone belongs to the Grishaverse series, and the author of this series is none other than Leigh Bardugo, who also happens to be one of the creators of the show. The actors did have the scripts in their hand for the show, but they needed to know their characters better. Therefore, they chose to use the Grishaverse books as a reference on the sets of the show. This activity really helped the actors to gain a little more insight into their role, get into their character, and have the right mindset for the character. Talk about well-researched acting! Number 3. Leigh Bardugo's cameo. Speaking of Leigh Bardugo, who happens to be the author of the book the show is based on, and she is also one of the creators of the show, you know all this information, don't you? However, one thing that you might not know is that she also made a cameo in the show. But that was one of the blink and you miss it cameos, and I bet most of the viewers did not see her there.
Hello!
Oh, you're here!
She appeared in the third episode of season 1, wearing a purple hand-embroidered kefta. She is the first Grisha to hug Alina when she shows the King and Queen of Ravka her sun summoner abilities. See if you can find her in the crowd, and do tell us if you already knew about this fact in the comment section below. Number 2. Kit Young's inspiration for his role as Jasper. Kit Young's portrayal of the witty Jasper was one of the best things about the show, but how did he do the role so well? Well, let's just say that Kit Young took some inspiration from some characters from different shows and movies that matched the profile of the character he was playing in Shadow and Bone. Kit Young took inspiration from iconic movie characters like Deadpool and Captain Jack Sparrow while preparing for the role. He also obviously studied a lot about Jasper's character itself using the original book and the provided script. This is how Kit Young did the role so well that it's hard to imagine anyone else in his place. To be honest, his role was a little more inspired to Captain Jack Sparrow compared to Deadpool.
I lost all of the money, but I managed to steal £20 of alabaster.
No, £16.
£16 of alabaster.
Number 1. Doctor Strange? Now, this is a strange one, isn't it? I mean, what does Doctor Strange from the Marvel Cinematic Universe have to do with this show? Did Benedict Cumberbatch make an appearance on the show as Doctor Strange that we all missed? Well, no, not at all. Benedict Cumberbatch has nothing to do with the show. However, the stunt team from the movie Doctor Strange did work with the creators of Shadow and Bone. The job of the Marvel stunt team was to work with Jessie in order to perfect her stunts and make sure that she does not get hurt, as most of the stunts were performed by the actors themselves. No wonder Jessie was so good in her fight sequences. That's all for today, folks. Hope you liked this video, and if you did, press the like button. Also, if you like our content and want us to make more amazing content, please hit the subscribe button. And while you're at it, don't forget to hit the bell icon so you get notified first whenever we post a video or any other update. Till then, have a nice day. See you soon.